Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 3.1, Module 3, Assignment Model, and the first lecture in the Assignment Model. We are going to discuss the Assignment Model, the theory of Assignment Model, the solution method for Assignment Model, and we will be solving problems in the assignment model. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the assignment model. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the linear programming problem, transportation problem, and here in this module, we will be discussing the assignment model. Assignment model or assignment problem is a kind of allocation problem which occurs in all workshops, companies and business enterprises. The objective is to assign n jobs to n machines or assigning n workers to n machines to optimize the effectiveness. The effectiveness may be minimizing the total distance traveled, minimizing the total time taken for completing the job, or maximizing the profit of the company. A similar type of problem can be solved by the linear programming problem or transportation problem. This is again, yet again, another method to solve such a type of problem. So, this is the mathematical model of the assignment model. There are m numbers of job designated as 1, 2, I and m, and n different machines designated as 1, 2, n. And the matrix shows the cost matrix. That is, job done by the machine 1, the cost is C11. Job done by the machine 2, is cost is C12. And similarly, the cost of doing the second job in the second machine is C22. And the doing the job, mth job in the nth machine is the CMN. And the value of each assignment value is 1. So, both value B1 equal to 1, B2 equal to 1, Bj equal to 1. Cij represent the cost of assigning ith job to the jth machine. The supply capacity of the source, that is job Ai equal to 1 for all values of I. And the demand for the destination, demand of the destination, that is machine, Bj equal to 1 for all values of j. Before solving the problem, we have to confirm that m equal to 1, m equal to n, that is the squareness of the matrix. If the matrix is not square, we have to add either dummy row or dummy column. If m is less than n, number of rows are less than number of column, then add dummy rows with the cell values equal to 0. And similarly, if m is greater than n, number of rows m is greater than number of column n, then add dummy column with the cell value equal to 0. The assignment problem mathematically expressed as, so minimize z equal to I value varies from 1 to m, sigma j values varies from 1 to n, Cij, Xij, subject to the constraints, sigma j equal to 1 to n, Xij equal to 1 for all values of I 1 to m, and sigma I equal to 1 to m, and Xij equal to 1 for all values of j equal to 1, 2, 3 up to n, and Xij equal to 0 or 1. Xij equal to 0 if ith job is not assigned to the jth machine. Xij equal to 1 if ith job is assigned to the jth machine. Solving the assignment problem, step 1, confirm the squareness of the matrix. If the given matrix is not square, then add dummy row or dummy column and make it as a square matrix. Step 2. In the first row, subtract the minimum cell value from all the other cell values and repeat the procedure for all the rows. So, we have to take the row first. So, first row, second row, like that we have to take. First row, subtract the minimum cell value. Among the cell values, you take the minimum cell value and subtract other cell values from the cell value and write the value, then repeat the procedure for all the rows. Step 3. Check that all the row and column consist of minimum 1 0. If not, subtract the minimum cell value of each column from all the other cell values in the same column. Then examine the first row. So we have to confirm every row and every column has got a zero value. After confirming that, step 4, examine the first row for an unmarked zero, mark square on this zero. That means that that assignment is made there. Then mark cross all the other zero in the same column. Repeat the procedure for all the other rows. Step 5, examine the first column for an unmarked zero. Mark this zero means that the assignment is made there, and mark cross and all the other zeros in the same row. Repeat the procedure for all the other column. Check that all the row and all the column have marked zero, square with square. If this condition is arrived, the assignment is optimum and find the solution. That is, optimum cost equal to sum of the assigned cell values. If the step is not achieved, if every cell and every column and every row does not have the assigned zero, then proceed to the step number 7. So, step number 7, mark a tick mark in the row for which assignment is to be made. Then mark step number 8, mark again tick mark in the column which does not have the assigned zero in the marked row. Step number 9, mark tick again the row in which row which is not already marked and has assigned zero in the marked column. Repeat the step number 7, 8, 9 till we get all the tick mark. Then step number 10, draw the line through all the unmarked rows and marked column. If the step were carefully followed, the number of lines passing through the matrix will be equal to number of assignments, and the minimum one line will be passing through each zero. The step number 11, examine the cell value on which the line is not passing and take the minimum value. Subtract the minimum value from all the other cell values on which line is not passing and add the minimum value wherever the lines intersect and leave other cell values as such. Now make the assignment again following the earlier procedure. If the assignment is incomplete, repeat from the procedure 7 and find the optimum assignment. So we'll follow the steps, all the 12 steps to solve different assignment problem. We'll take the first example. Solve the following assignment problem. The workers are assigned to the job. So we have 4 workers and 4 jobs. So it is a square matrix, and the cell values are given: 45, 40, 51, 67, 57, 42, 63 and 55, 49, 52, 48, 64, 41, 45, 60 and 55. These are all the cell values. The cell values represents when you allot the worker 1 to the job A, the cost is 45. When you allot the worker 1 to the job D, the cost is 67. Similarly, when you allot the worker 3 to the job 2, the cost is 52. When you allot the worker 3 to the job C, the cost is 48. Then when you allot the worker 4 to the job 1 is 41, the cost is 41. Similarly, when you allot the worker 4 to the job D, it is 55. The number of workers and number of jobs are equal. It is a square matrix. So, first step, minimum value of the row 1 is 40. Subtract 40 from all the other cell values and write here. So, 45 minus 45, 0, 11, 27. And in the second row, the minimum value is 42. Subtract 42 from the remaining cell values in the same row. 15, 0, 21, 13. And in the third row, the minimum value is 48. Subtract 48 from other values. 1, 4, 0, 16. And in the fourth row, the minimum value is 41. So subtract 41 from all the other cell values. 0, 4, 19 and 14. Then the column D does not have the 0. So you look at the value here. Row A has got the 0, row 1 has got the 0, row 2 has got the 0, row 3 has got the 0, row 4 has got the 0, column A has got 1 0, column B has got 2 zeros, column C has got 1 0, and column D there is no 0. Now you take the column D, again the minimum value is 13. So column D does not have the 0, subtract the minimum value 13 from all the other cell values in the same column and write the value here. So now the values are 5 0 11 14, 15 0 21 0, 1 4 0 3, and 0 4 19 1. Now we go for the assignment. Row 1, mark the 0 on the column B and cross the other 0 in the same column. So we mark the 0 here, write a, put a square on the 0 and cross the in the same column. If you have 0, you cross the 0. That means in that column the assignment is made. In the row 2, mark 0 on the column D. So here I have a 0, I mark the 0. In row 3, we have 1 0 here. So you mark the 0. And in the row 4, we have 1 0. So mark the column A, this is 0. Now if you look at here, worker 1 is assigned to job B, worker 2 is assigned to job D, worker 3 is assigned to job C, and worker 4 is assigned to job A. So all the workers are assigned, all the jobs are assigned. So the solution, we have the solution. All the workers are allotted to the jobs. So optimum assignment is 1 to B, 2 to D, 3 to C, and 4 to A. The optimum cost of assignment, sum of the cell values, original cell values 40 plus 55 plus 48 plus 41, which is 184. Rupees 184 is the cost of assigning the worker to the job. We take another example, example number 2. It is again minimization type of problem. 4 jobs A, B, C, D are to be assigned to 4 machines P, Q, R, S. The processing costs are given below. Find the allocation which will minimize the overall processing cost. So there are 4 jobs A, B, C, D and 4 machines P, Q, R, S. It is a square matrix. Number of rows are equal to number of columns. So it is a square matrix. So the cell values represent the cost of processing the job in a particular machine. Number of machines and number of jobs are equal. It is a square matrix. So we take the matrix again here. And the minimum value in the row A is 39. So you subtract 39 from all the other values. So the values are 2, 33, 0, 13. And in the second row, the minimum value is 22. Subtract 22 from all the other values, 0, 7, 27, 43. And in the third row, the minimum value is 27. Subtract 27 from all the other values, 0, 12, 33, 24. In the fourth row, the minimum value is 45. Subtract 45 from all the other values, 0, 5, 3, and 7. Now, row 1 has got 0. Row 2 has got the 0. Row 3, C row got the 0. D row has got the 0. P, column P has got 3 zeros. Column Q, there is no 0. R has got 1 0. Column S does not have the 0. Now we have to repeat the procedure with the column. Now the table is repeated again here. Now column Q and column S does not possess 0. Column Q and column S does not possess 0. The minimum value of in the column Q is 5. Subtract 5 from all the other value in the same column. So you repeat here 2, 0, 0, 28, 2, 7 and 5. And the third row as it is 0, 27, 33 and 3. Minimum value of the column is S is 7. So here it is 7. So subtract 7 from all the other values. So the values are 6, 36, 17 and 0. Now all the rows and all the columns they have 0. Now we can make the assignment. So the table is, the matrix is repeated again. We make the assignment now. First assignment, assign job A to the machine R. So we have only 1 0, you assign here. So this is assigned. Vertically, look at the table vertically, there is no other 0. Then we go to the next assignment. Job B is assigned to the machine P. In the second row, there is only 1 0. So we have to assign the job B to the machine P. So this is the assignment. And we have 2 0 vertically. There are in the same column, we have 2 zeros. We have to cross the 0. That means you should not make assignment here because already the machine P is occupied. Then we go to the third assignment. assign job D to the machine S, because in the C row there is no other zero. This zero we cannot assign, so there is no other zero, so C is not assigned. Now we take D. There are two unassigned zero. We take assign job D to the machine S and cross the other zero in the same row. So here we mark the assignment and we cross the zero. This zero we cannot make because this job is assigned and this machine is occupied. Now the assignment is incomplete because job C is not assigned and the machine Q is free. So job C is not assigned, Q is free. So this is incomplete assignment. We have to optimize the solution. Now that same table again, same matrix is repeated here. Now mark tick in the row where the assignment is required. So we require assignment in this row C. You put a mark here. Then mark tick in the column which possess the zero in the marked row. So this is the marked row. Where do you find zero? In the first column we have the zero. So you mark tick here. So first step, you mark the row where you require assignment. Second step, you identify zero here, unassigned zero here, and mark a tick mark in this column where we have zero, unassigned zero. Then mark tick in the row which possess zero, that is here we have the assigned zero in the same column. So this is the row. Now draw a line through unmarked row and marked column. So what are the unmarked row? So this is unmarked row. A is unmarked row and D is unmarked row. Marked column, P is the marked column. Now we have one vertical line, two horizontal line. The total number of lines passing is 3. So the assignments are 3. So one assignment is left. So number of lines crossing the matrix is equal to number of assignments already made. So it is 3. Now look at here. So among the cell values, what are the cell values on which the line is not passing? 2, 27, 36, 7, 33 and 17. Among the 6 values, the minimum value is 2. So now we have to subtract 2 from all the other cell values and add 2 in the line wherever it is crossing. So here it is crossing, we have to add 2 here, and here again we have to add 2. So subtract 2 from the cell values, the 6 cell values, and add 2 wherever the line is crossing, leave other cell values as it is. So repeating the following the procedure, we will get 4, 28, 0, 0, 0, 6, 0, 0, 25, 34, 0, 5, 31, 15 and 2, 0, 3, 0. Now again check it up. Every row, A row we have 0, B row we have 2 zeros, C row we have 1 0, D row we have 2 zeros, P column we have 2 zeros, Q column we have 2 zeros, R column we have 1 0, S column we have 1 0. Now we take the assignment again. Assign job A to the machine R. So this is the assignment. Then assign job B to the machine Q. Then cross the 0 in the same column. So here we make the assignment and here we have 1 0, you cross the 0. Then assign job C to the machine P. Then we mark here. Then cross the other zero in the same column and assign job D to the machine S. Now job A is assigned to R, job B is assigned to Q, job C is assigned to P and job D is assigned to S. So all the jobs are assigned and all the machines are occupied. So this is the optimum solution. The solution is complete. So the optimum assignment: A to job A to machine R, job B to machine Q, job C to machine P, and the job D to machine S. Now the optimum processing cost is the sum of the original cost values, 39 plus 29 plus 27 plus 52. The cost is rupees 147. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Operation Research. You refer to the book for more information on the assignment model. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the assignment model. Until then, bye.